All right, so we're going to open up this never opened NBC suit, nuclear biological chemical suit. This one, I believe, is the six color desert camouflage, which is kind of rare. Most of these were made in woodland, so it should be interesting to see. It's dated 1990 with an inspection date of 691. And these were basically charcoal lined suits you'd wear over your standard uniform to protect from chemical, biological, probably limited radioactive protection, but you know, hopefully you wouldn't be in any of those environments very long. So we'll go ahead and see what this thing looks like. Okay, so kind of slice it from the top and see what we got going on. All right, so we're going to kind of preserve the package here. We're going to slice this kind of like we would an MRE bag and see what they got inside here. Once these are open, they apparently have a 4-hour shelf life, like 4-hour use life before you're supposed to switch to a new one. So there it is. And it sure enough is the six color desert, which is pretty cool because there's not a lot of this equipment out here. It was in use for a limited kind of time. If you don't know, this camouflage was developed in the 60s. When we thought we might get involved in some of the Middle East-Israeli conflicts, but that didn't happen. So then it was kind of shelved for a while until it was brought back in the 80s and then used in the Gulf War. And it was kind of phased out in the early 90s by the three-color desert camouflage. So it's kind of in a big roll, which is neat. I'm going to try to put it back in that roll when I'm done. So if you've never encountered one of these suits, they're very, like, thick and heavily. It's a very, like, pretty heavy material. Let's see. This is our, well, that's our top. And here are our pants. Down inside there. Oh, there's, like, a giant desiccant pack to keep it fresh. That's kind of neat. So the pants pretty much mimic your standard BDU trousers. But they're lined with this charcoal lining, as you can see. So that starts to break down after a while, but that's what, like, absorbs the chemicals. Your pockets all Velcro. They're surprisingly really high quality for something that's, like, temporary use. So there's another giant desiccant pack. So there's here's our top. And you can see some of that charcoal kind of. There's some staining because it started to break down. But you have a collar. These early ones just had a collar. The newer ones have a hood because the gas mask from this time had the hood built into it, and you put this over it. So you can imagine wearing this mask and this suit in the desert heat in Iraq in the first Gulf War and the second Gulf War. It was pretty miserable. And they wore these for an extended period, because they thought there was a good chance that Saddam would use chemical weapons, because he did against his own people. So that's just a look at the chemical suit. I also have this kind of interesting book on NBC defense inside the tank. And if anyone has an interest on that, I could upload pictures and send it to you. But I just thought that was kind of a neat little item. So, any questions, if anyone wants to see more of that type of equipment, just comment below. But we're going to move on to the ration now. All right, so we've chosen out of a limited collection we have of these vintage brown bag MREs, menu number 6, which is the Frankfurters beef with accessory packet A. This was known as the Five Fingers of Death by some troops. I think they soldiers just like to come up with fun names, but some of these were kind of known to, you know, give you the shits or something, so they would kind of come up with names like that. We'll see how well this preserved. We're going to go and slice her open and see. I don't know if we'll be eating the Frankfurters, but if you want to see that, I know Steve did a review of one of these where he did, in fact, eat the hot dogs.
All of them, I think.
Yeah, he's a brave man. I'll admit, I'm not as brave. We got the charms. That's pretty cool. They don't put those.
Pretty good, actually.
Yeah, they don't put those in MREs anymore. Oop, hit the camera stand. We have our, what is this? It's freeze-dried. Is this the fruit bar? Mm-hmm. What does it say? Yes, fruit mix. This stuff was apparently famously good. The freeze-dried fruit. From what I've heard in other videos, those are like really popular. This is the freeze-dried fruit bar. So this is starting off looking pretty good. Our heater. I'm not even going to attempt to use that because I know it's not any good. Oh, 1993 date. So it's technically post Gulf War, but this is right before they switched to the light brown bag. There's the beef Frankfurters. So that's a little packet. The spoon. Interestingly, the early brown bag MREs did not have a heater, if I remember correctly. Potato sticks. Oh, those are like those potato fry things. I haven't had those in years. And these are almost as old as we are, so that'll be pretty interesting. The accessory packet. We're going to probably imagine that coffee isn't any good, considering our last one wasn't. Sugar-free diet soft drink mix, fruit punch. That's a tiny little pack compared to the one we had in the
noobs. How much water was it supposed to add? 8 ounces. Wow. Okay.
Oh, the cocoa beverage powder. Now, this is good stuff.
It looks really good. Like, remember the packaging looks really good.
The one we had in that winter ration that was from the 80s was still fantastic. Peanut butter. The peanut butter very well may still be good because in the one video, I tried peanut butter out of this 1960s, one of these cans, and it was still fine. So, that'll be interesting. And looks like lastly, we have the crackers. So that kind of gives you an idea of everything that came in here. And I guess we'll go ahead and see what we want to open up first and be right back. All right, so since we know that heater isn't any good, we're going to get some water going on the fuel tab. So we're going to break out our matches out of our accessory packet. And we're going to heat up the Frankfurters that way. And then we'll also see if we can make that coffee on an off chance that it's okay. See if it'll light. Maybe. I think it's going to go. Come on, little fuel tab. And maybe not. Let's try that again. Light. Surprised it's not lighting. Those things usually light. Here,
can you use one of the...
Oh, yeah. Let's get out one of the jumbo matches.
Oh, we never opened this one.
Yeah, it's sealed. That's okay. I'll have to crack it open. I mean, they got to get used for something. But if we can get that water heated, we can warm them up that way and see what they look like.
Do you still have the match bar?
Oh, yep.
Go ahead and wait. Figured we'd just use the...
Yeah, use that for the striker.
Or not.
Really? Must not like that striker. Experiencing technical difficulties. Try that way. That's a serious match. Like, if we get that thing lit...
Yeah.
It's foreign. It doesn't like our U.S. striker, I guess.
Because this one looks way better.
Yeah, like the little strip somehow you're supposed to light.
Here, I'm gonna do something more. This makes more sense. With
Polish fuel tabs, U.S. matches. Sometimes it doesn't like it. Light it that way. There we go. That thing's burning.
My God. Okay.
Yeah, that's a serious match. Geez. That doesn't light up, then we got problems.
I think it's lit because it's just burning the wood. Oh, are you serious?
Okay, we'll be back in a moment because apparently these fuel tabs aren't good anymore. Oh, all right, well, 6 matches later, that Polish fuel tab finally heated up. So, apparently hard to light. Thankfully, you get plenty of matches in the accessory pack. Oh, wow, look at that. Little hot dogs. That is... interesting. Well, so we're just going to stick those in there and kind of let them heat up. And we'll see what happens. So what do you want to try next, Nate?
I
want to
check this out.
Oh, the height. Yeah, we'll need water for that, too. That's the fruit bar. Although I think, if I've heard, you could eat it just dry.
I want to take a nibble dry. If I can work the...
Come on now. There it is. Could use another half of the mess tin there. Set it out for everyone to see. That's kind of neat. You know what it looks like? A rice cake.
I've seen people eat these, and I've always wanted to eat one.
I know. This is the first time we've encountered one. You need a... what are you looking for? Something to put it on?
Yeah, just... There we go.
Yeah, just set it on the mess tin there.
Wow.
That's interesting.
It has like indents of something.
27-year-old freeze-dried fruit. They don't make these anymore, that's for sure.
But oh,
it's
okay.
Like space food.
Yeah, that's why I want to eat it.
It's like space ice cream.
Yeah, it like doesn't look weird or anything in the middle.
Dude, it tastes like space ice cream.
Oh, well, this is really good. No wonder everyone likes this.
Yeah, this is actually fabulous.
Yeah, there's no need to reconstitute this.
It's like, if anyone's had space ice cream, imagine that, but tastes like fruit cocktail. That is a wonder of 20th century technology right there.
Yeah,
I don't know why they don't make that anymore.
I had a bit of banana, too. That was really good.
It's actually disappointing if they don't make it anymore, because this is probably the last time I'll ever eat one of these.
Yeah, maybe they'll bring it back.
That's what I love about these 80s and 90s rations. There's some really unique stuff you can't get anymore. Like the fruit soup.
Yeah, that'll never come back.
Nope. That was like a short-lived, fabulous thing. Those are just your standard charms. They're probably fine. But the little fruit candies. Those were put in U.S. rations going back to World War II. But I don't think they put them in anymore.
No, they don't even have a like charm alternative.
No, you just get M&M's.
Or Skittles. Actually, I think they stopped doing Skittles some time ago.
Yeah. Maybe they got rid of candies in general. I don't know.
Some of them have candy. The tuna MREs have the most candy. I'm like, try not to ruin the...
Yeah, the package. We need to kind of save it for display. You get a knife?
Yeah.
Still got cheese sauce on it from earlier.
Oh, yeah. Gross cheese sauce. There we go. Oh, well, it kind of melted a little bit.
A little melty?
Yeah.
Now, we know Steve's eating charms from sea rations going back to World War II, so these things do tend to hold up, but they can get a little melty.
Well, I might need that again.
Continue to peel it.
It just, like, keeps getting stuck.
Mm-hmm. I guess you get that open. We'll see what these potato fries look like for just potato sticks. I might do the same thing, but like carefully kind of open the pack.
There we go.
Pour a few of those babies out of there. I was 3 years old when these rolled off the assembly line. So that's kind of interesting to think about it in itself. I'm going to taste one. They still look totally fine. And honestly, they taste relatively okay. Just tastes like potato chips. And they're still crunchy. They're not even stale. Oh, did you get one out?
Yeah. Yep. I think I'm going to leave that.
You got an orange flavor.
It's pretty melted.
Yeah, the packaging kind of stuck to it, unfortunately. So, I'm sure it's still good. We'd have to go to the trouble of peeling the stuff off of it, which I think Steve's had to do. But those are 27-year-old potatoes, and they're still fresh.
Oh, they taste pretty good.
Yeah, I'm amazed.
Yeah, not, like, stale at all.
Starting to see some steam come off here. I wonder if we should, like, flip it. Eat the other side. Hold on. Fell down in there. Did I put out the fuel tip?
They went out.
I did. That's all right. That's pretty hot. So I think those are, they're kind of warm.
We might not want to use this for that.
All right, so after several technical failures with our U.S. canteen cup stove, we decided to switch to the vintage German Hespit over there, and it's working just fine. So I guess we'll see what these crackers and peanut butter look like. These crackers are almost always good because they're shrink-wrapped, freeze-dried. Not freeze-dried, but just vacuum-packed, rather. Of course, getting them open is another challenge. Ooh, nice hiss. So that's a good sign. Getting that stuff open.
Stuck on there?
Yeah. That shrink wrap is like...
Yeah, sometimes I would break those to get them out.
They almost always broken.
Yeah, there you go.
These were more or less intact, which is pretty impressive. And these are always delicious. Something about them, they're simple, but they're good. Yeah, still totally fine. I'll be interested to see what this peanut butter is like, because we've eaten sea ration peanut butter and far older, and it was still good, so. Oh, look at that. Still looks totally fresh. Looks like Jif made yesterday.
Still oily, yeah.
Yeah. I think peanut butter just is naturally shelf stable. Okay. Let's see what that's about.
I'm gonna spread mine a little.
Yeah, I'm gonna use the spoon that came with it. See what this 27-year-old peanut butter tastes like. I'm not gonna lie, it has a slightly weird taste.
Oh, it does smell kind of
so
metallic-y.
Yeah, almost like it's taken on some of the packaging. Not as good as that stuff from Vietnam, to be honest. I mean, I think it's still edible. It just kind of, I think it's absorbed some of the packaging. I think that's what's happened. So.
Yep, definitely has a strange taste.
Yeah, I don't think we'll eat any more of that. Everything so far, though, is pretty well preserved. I think our water's pretty hot. Yeah, if we want to try our cocoa. Do some here real quick. This is our old stand, so we don't burn the... Yeah, that cup's pretty hot. So we'll let those hot dogs continue to boil. I mean, I don't think we're going to try them, but might as well see what they look like.
Yeah, if they're not bad, I'll try them.
Alright. So we have the cocoa. This stuff is almost always good, and it's, like, fabulous. It's better, like, than the stuff you get in the store now.
Yeah, looks good.
It does. I'd say that's fine. Does it have any off-putting smell? Like the dairy's gone sour, right? It's powdered.
I don't think so.
No, I think it's still good. Yeah. Let's go ahead and pour that in there. Okay, stir that baby up. Curious if our taster's choice is dry molded. Oh, yeah. Yep. As typical, this coffee is a moldy cake. So we won't be making any mocha. That's disappointing. But I am looking forward to tasting the hot chocolate.
Right, I think the chunks are out of it.
Yeah, I think so. I guess we'll let that cool a little bit. You can see what our sugar-free diet soft drink mix is like.
That's right, I mean. Pretty flat. And
it's closer to you. I'll let you put it in there. Makes 8 ounces. See what it's like. I find it interesting they went with a diet fruit punch, you know, for a military ration.
Oh.
Does it smell better than the Chinese ration?
It smells like grape. doesn't even smell.
Oh, it's weird. Yeah. It has a weird smell. I'll go ahead and dump it in. It's like a stale, fruity smell.
Might get a little chocolate in there, but...
It'd be alright.
It's not mixing that great.
Yeah, it's old. While you stir that, I guess I'll taste this hot cocoa. The hot cocoa is surprisingly good.
Okay. I think it actually stirred.
It can't be
to
worse.
Be pretty good, actually.
Can't be worse than the Chinese stuff.
Yeah, it's like a good Swiss miss.
It is. Alright, we're gonna flip those one more time.
I don't know that black stuff floating in there is.
I don't know if
part of it or
not. I don't know where that came from. Maybe it was in the cup.
I'm just gonna drink from the other side.
Just drink from the other side, hope for the best. Oh, I don't think you're gonna drink the whole thing anyway, so.
Oh, dude, this is the OG fruit punch.
Yeah.
It tastes just like the normal fruit punch from now.
Dude, that is good.
It's literally like the same fruit punch.
It's like Hawaiian punch, and it doesn't have a diet flavor at all.
No.
Dude, that's
I have no clue why it says diet.
That's actually fabulous. So far, the hot chocolate was good. The potato sticks were good. The fruit punch was actually really refreshing. The peanut butter, I think, is still edible, but it has a weird metallic-y taste.
Yeah.
And the crackers are still good, so...
Oh, the stove just went out.
So all right, I think
those hot dogs are...
They're done.
Good.
Okay. All right, so we're going to set those there. Let me clear out the stove real quick. All right, so we've boiled our four fingers of death, 27-year-old hot dogs from an MRE, so... We're gonna peel this baby open and see what they look like. Oh, look at those things.
They look great.
They actually do. They smell like little smokies. And they look totally preserved. That is amazing.
They're in a solid chunk together.
Yeah, they are.
But,
maybe the casing has them together.
Oh, boy. They're like...
They're just stuck together. Wow, look at those. They smell totally fine. I mean, there's so many preservatives.
I think there's like black pepper or something in the...
Yeah, maybe. Let's see what the ingredients say. Ingredients: beef, water, salt, sugar, flavorings, sodium triphosphate, spices, sodium erythrobrate, and sodium nitrate. So lots of salt. So they probably last a nuclear apocalypse. And Nate has tried one. Nate has tried a 27-year-old hot dog. What's the verdict?
I think it's good.
Well, I think the one Steve ate were from 1982,
It's smoky.
They smelled like little smokies.
It's like, not like crazy heavy, though, when you're drinking it.
Eating it, you mean?
Yeah.
Drinking the hot dog? Well?
Oh.
What do you got?
I don't know.
I don't know what's going on there.
I don't know if that weight is good or bad.
I don't know either. I wouldn't eat any more. But it is a 27-year-old hot dog. And I think, honestly, you'd probably be okay, but...
Oh, it's just the one, though. That might actually...
It may have just been some residue off the tray.
I'm going to eat more.
Nate is a brave soul. So, well, if Nate doesn't make it, donations can be made out to the organization in his memory.
They're actually really good.
That's pretty astonishing. But not surprising when you think about it. It's basically salted meat, which it's been shrink-wrapped. So there's really no reason why it should spoil. So I guess that concludes our four fingers of death. Hopefully you enjoyed this video. And seeing Nate eat 27-year-old hot dogs. And comment below, like, and subscribe, and we appreciate it.